See your dealer today.
What are you waiting for?
You're watching ABC7 New York.
The response was overwhelming. Gary Zukav is back. Monday's Oprah.
Good evening. I'm Hugh Downs.
And I'm Barbara Walters. And you are joining us on a very special night, the last time that Hugh will be co-host of 2020. Tonight, a heartfelt send-off for our own Hugh Downs. For 60 years, broadcasting to America. For 21 years, the steadfast anchor of 2020. Tonight, an hour that captures a lifetime. Relive Hugh's greatest adventures. Soar with him again to the loftiest heights, into brave new worlds.
Houston, we do not have a problem.
Into the operating room.
The hammering woke me up.
For the knee surgery that would put a new bounce in his step, and share unforgettable moments from his most compelling interviews. Then Hugh's last assignment for 2020, into the heart of Indonesia, where something surprisingly simple is changing millions of lives. And the interview I've been waiting years to do.
What can I do to make you cry?
You'll learn things about Hugh you never knew before. And we've thrown in a few surprises for him and you.
Folks are excited about Hugh.
So we invite you to toast the beginning of new endeavors and the end of an extraordinary run for Hugh Downs. 21 years at 2020. Okay, this is it, partner. This is our last duet at 2020. My co-host and dear friend for more than 30 years is moving on after 21 years at this desk. Are you sure you want to do this?
I've changed my mind.
I would hope so, because parting is such sweet sorrow. I mean, along with the excitement, and it's the sense of loss, and yet we know that you're going to head off to, shall we say, new fields of dreams. But not without a proper send-off, because tonight we want to share with you, our viewers, the Hugh Downs that we have had the fun and the honor of working with.
Well, I thank you, Barbara, for many things, really. It has been fun. There's no doubt about that. For me, also, quite lucky, because over the past 21 years, I've been sent off, quite happily, I might say, literally to the ends of the earth many times, in search of stories and people that might touch your lives, maybe even change them for the better. You know, I've often been asked, as I know you have, what is your most memorable story, your favorite interview? Well, here is the closest I could come to an answer.
Hey, there's Coco.
In 1985, I was given the assignment to travel to California to the Gorilla. It was a chance to meet Coco, who was part of a language study program. She had a remarkable vocabulary of over 550 signs. But it was in the waters off South Australia where the tables were turned, and now I was in the cage, and my visitor was the great white shark. As he swam by me, I reached out and grabbed his pectoral fin. The skin felt like tiny beads glued onto steel. At SeaWorld in Florida, while doing a story on killer whales bred in captivity, I gained the trust of Kandu and was privileged to have an unforgettable ride on this powerful animal. Covering adventure stories let me be more than a reporter. I became a cowboy in the Great West in search of wild mustangs to tame.
I volunteered to go in there with you and help you, but that would only louse things up.
You want to go in there first?
What's our speed now?
I was a space shuttle commander during a landing exercise in NASA's motion-based simulator.
Houston, we do not have a problem.
And even experienced weightlessness on board what NASA affectionately calls the Vomit Comet. In 1983, I accompanied treasure hunters and archaeologists in their search for lost gold. My old colleague Geraldo Rivera and I went diving in the Caribbean for a sunken 18th century Spanish galleon said to be worth over $100 million. In Mexico, deep in an ancient Mayan ruin, our 2020 cameras were there when a piece of history was unearthed.
You know, you're looking at a bowl for the first time since it was placed, you know, 1,300 years ago.
We'll go down this side of the wreck.
And last year, marine archaeologists excavated the wreck of a ship which sank during the time of the Crusades off southern Turkey. many stories allowed me to report from under the sea, one of my favorite places. For example, scuba diving in the Florida Keys, where 60 feet below the surface is the underwater laboratory called Aquarius. These scientists are able to work here for weeks at a time, studying both inside and outside the habitat.
It, whatever that it was in me, had a name.
The it actress Patty Duke is talking about is manic depression. In this moving interview, she told me how this mental illness led to her suicide attempts.
When you really took steps to do that, what happened? What did you do?
It's very odd to sit here and answer you and look down the hallway and know that that's the bedroom. That's the bed from which I could not get up unless it was to go in and attempt suicide.
Personal stories were often compelling, the people always fascinating. I traveled with Zubin Mehta and the New York Philharmonic, touring his homeland in India. The Dalai Lama talked with me about his exile from Tibet and concerns for his people. And one of my favorite interviews took place in Cambridge, England, with the theoretical physicist Stephen Hawking, who suffers from Lou Gehrig's disease and speaks through the aid of a computer.
We all need to know where we come from and what may happen in the future. Otherwise, life just seems pointless.
Barry Goldwater looked back on his 84 years and took a guess at how he would be remembered in the history books.
I don't know how they're going to treat me. I may be the worst SOB that ever came down the pike, but I won't lose any sleep over it.
I talked with the Reverend Billy Graham and his wife Ruth. And we touched on, of all things, dating etiquette.
I've read that you did not even kiss your wife until you were engaged. Does that seem overly stringent to you now, or was that...
No, I had kissed other girls.
I see.
Jackie Gleason proved to be a colorful interview. Here in his Florida home, the centerpiece of his playroom was a huge sunken bar complete with safety nets.
These chairs are set in tight, so no matter how loaded you get, you can't fall out.
And I was the victim of quick-witted Mel Brooks, who turned a serious question into a punchline.
You did lose your father before you were three.
Believe me, we lost him. He died.
Yes.
We didn't lose him. If he went to Pitkin Avenue and we couldn't find him, that would be losing him.
Losing him.
But my father actually died. I mean, they buried him.
Among the most rewarding assignments, watching UNICEF doctors make a difference in the lives of children in some of the most remote areas of the world. In this village in the Philippines, vitamin A deficiency caused an alarming amount of night blindness in children. Catching it in time with a simple 2-cent megadose of the vitamin resulted in a miraculous turnaround. Here in Bangladesh, children severely dehydrated from diarrhea and at the point of certain death were brought back to health by drinking a simple solution of salt, sugar, potassium, and baking soda. Whether sailing on the open seas or soaring through the skies, from taking an unforgettable walk around the world at the South Pole to playing a game of softball at the North Pole, it's been a wonderful journey.
And what a wonderful legacy to be proud of. And I'm so happy that no matter where your travels took you, you came back right here to my side.
Well, they were great adventures, but you were so nice to come home to.
Well, Hugh, throughout the hour tonight, you're going to be hearing from some of your biggest fans, not just me. They have been lining up to say a few words from the heart, and here is our first surprise. You haven't seen this.
1939 to 1999. It is amazing. There are no accidents in big-time broadcasting. For Hugh Downs to survive. No, for Hugh Downs to flourish over a 60-year career is testament to the wisdom and the good taste of the American people. This guy is a giant. He's my best friend in the business, the only colleague I ever went sailing with and diving and gliding. This guy is incredible, and television and the country are going to miss him. I know I do. Sail on, partner. Sail on.
There it goes again.
Have you had the Czech experience?
It's all about crunching squares, basically. Squares? We're square people. Well,
the squares go crunch.
Squares make a good crunch.
It's the Chexplosion of milk and crunch you only get from Chex.
Wait, get me that. Flex still has squares.
The crunch delivers the milk.
Ding dong, milk is here.
If you have the Chexperience,
it's good.
The new Lincoln LS.
When it's time to clean your outside windows, does the job seem this big? Next time, try Windex Outdoor. Its concentrated formula and sheeting action dissolve tough grime to get windows clean. Windex Outdoor. A beautiful shine, a lot less time.
You know, I wonder if you can fix that truck again.
E-tailers like Amazon.com choose Priority Mail. Shouldn't you?
It's a great pleasure for me to join many, many others in saluting Hugh Downs on his retirement. He will be sorely missed. Everyone in broadcasting has always said the same thing about Hugh Downs, and it drives them crazy. Hugh Downs is normal. Best of luck, you. We love you.
Well, he's not entirely normal. I won't tell. Anyway, one thing I do know is you have been mostly a very private person. But 3 years ago, Hugh decided to break with that tradition at a very vulnerable time in your life.
Yes. I remembered it well.
Well, Hugh was going in for serious surgery on both his knees. And the producers at 2020 persuaded him to let the cameras follow him into the operating room.
Well, actually, I'm not an exhibitionist, but I thought that watching these medical mechanics at work would be a marvel. And I also thought that if I could get through this successfully, it might reassure others who face the problem and have the same condition.
The deterioration of my knee joints and the pain that came with it was slow but relentless. And after 52 years of marriage to Ruth, leaning on my spouse had become more than a catchphrase. It was quite literal. My diagnosis was traumatic arthritis, or osteoarthritis, in both knees. It's what 90% of knee replacement patients have. My surgery was set for January 27th, a Saturday, so I could host 2020 the night before.
Hugh, we're a little concerned, so you tell us why we shouldn't be.
I won't be here next week because tomorrow morning I am having some surgery. Total joint replacement in both knees.
No!
I was determined to be back in 2 weeks. As I walked out of the studio that night, I was, indeed, on my last legs.
Ruth, our grandson Cameron, and I arrived in Boston at Harvard's Mass General Hospital before dawn on Saturday.
What was his mood this morning?
He was a little nervous and a little concerned. Was I going to remember to bring his CDs and his reading material? And when was I going to bring his suitcase?
Are you ready?
All set.
Okay.
You're
ready.
As I was wheeled in for the four-hour operation, Dr. Jasty, one of 10,000 surgeons in the country who does knee replacements, was suiting up.
Who is a good candidate for total joint replacement of the knees?
In general, we like to do this operation on people who are 60 years or older. The reason for that is that there is a 95% chance that your knee joints will last between 18 and 20 years. That's a pretty good track record.
Yeah, I'll be close to retirement.
The operation is a marvel of biomechanical engineering. The deformed ends of the bones are removed and replaced with snug-fitting titanium and cobalt chromium implants. A curved femoral component on top and a flat tibial plate on the bottom. A slab of ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene plastic snaps between them and acts as the cartilage. And another reinforces what remains of the kneecap. Four new parts. I had an epidural, not a general anesthetic. And that, combined with relaxants, allowed me to stay awake and watch the whole thing on a monitor. I know I don't look it, but at the time I felt totally alert.
The experience is borders on being euphoric and very educational.
Can I have the saw cutting guide?
To ensure a tight fit of the prostheses, the bones are shaved using these high precision metal guides. It sounded a bit like an auto body shop.
The hammering woke me up.
One down, Mr. Downs. One more to go.
It was all over in 4 hours, on schedule. I spent the next 10 days in the hospital, fairly normal for two knees. As the anesthetic wore off, the pain surfaced and the hard work began.
Now bend up this left knee. Bend it. God, there you go. Bend.
I was told I could expect to use crutches or a walker for 2 months.
He presented it to me as a non-negotiable, going to work on Friday. The knee's nice and straight, so we've all put our, you know, minds to work, and actually we've developed some good strategies, and I think he'll be ready for Friday's show.
Good evening, I'm Hugh Downs.
Welcome back. You are a marvel.
Glad to be back.
Stubborn, Barbara, but hardly a marvel. I had gotten there, but with the help of a wheelchair. There were months of intensive therapy ahead, and more than a year before the knees felt like mine. My before and after x-rays tell it all. The old me, bone on bone, and the new bionic me, with the two bones a good half inch apart. I got my new knees 3.5 years ago when I was 75, and I have put them to good use. Most recently, they took me to Indonesia, as you'll see in a few minutes. For me, it's a lot better than just staying alive.
But it wasn't easy.
No, I don't want to mislead, because there were some trying times, and the therapy after surgery was long and sometimes a little difficult. But for me, the payoff made it all worth it.
And it was for us, too. Well, we have much more, many more surprises on this special night. Stay with us.
You know, all my life, I just wanted to be like you, Downs. Distinguished, urbane, witty, informed, sexy. Sorry to see him go. He's been my idol for a long, long time.
We'll miss you. We love you. We know you'll be around.
Absolutely. You can't keep
Barbara
you Downs
Walters
off television.
Barbara is going to fall apart. What's she going to do without you?
I don't know, but that's Barbara's problem right now. Well, you, good luck to you. We'll
God
see you again on TV.
You.
Thanks for 21 great years on 2020.
Today, I blackmailed my boss for almost $60,000 past these fairs.
The critics are calling American Beauty stunning, hilarious, poignant.
If I had to leave tonight, would you come with me?
Yes.
Remarkable and altogether extraordinary. A unique masterpiece, such as The Graduate and Ordinary People.
There happens to be a lot about me that you don't know, Mr. Smarty Man.
American Beauty, rated R, now playing in select cities, coming soon to a theater near you.
When I had trouble getting rid of headaches with the leading pain reliever, I assumed the problem was my headaches were too tough. But you know what? The problem wasn't my headaches. It was my medicine. Because when I tried Excedrin, everything changed. My headaches went away. Completely away. Excedrin's just on a whole other level. So my headaches are still tough. But Excedrin's tougher.
Excedrin, the headache medicine.
If you think St. John's Bed clothing feels good on your body, wait till you feel what it does for your head. All the pocket zippers and hoods you need to go gently down life's stream. St. John's Bay, clothes that fit your state of mind. Every day's the weekend in St. John's Bay, only at JCPenney.
Where do some of America's most successful people get their start? Did somebody say McDonald's?
Testimonials, and you're saying, yes, Gene, by unleashing the power of visualization, I can change my life. But what, Gene? What can I visualize to become a leader?
A giant among my peers.
While achieving a sense of inner calm. Close your eyes and picture yourself as this.
Accord from Honda. It's one powerful car.
It's color and texture that create an overall design scheme.
I've always believed that form should follow function.
Introducing EA Kids by Ethan Allen.
It's the comforter really that ties the whole room together.
There's a sale on now.
ABC Sunday. Two David Kelly shows, one great premiere night. First, Snoops, the new series critics say will be huge. Then, The Practice, the winner of four Emmys, including Best Drama, is back. Catch Snoops series premiere, followed by The Practice season premiere. ABC Sunday, starting at 9, 8 Central.
Gotcha.
It was love at first sight that made Once and Again the new season's biggest hit.
What will we do with each other for a whole evening?
Cela Ward and Billy Campbell are single parents trying dating once and again.
You're so beautiful.
Time magazine says you have to love Once and Again. Tuesday, 10, 9 Central. Viewer discretion advised.
Hello, I'm Alex Trebek, and here is today's special Final Jeopardy clue. Though he's known for other things, this man hosted Concentration for 11 years, 5 years more than I did. The correct response, of course, who is Hugh Downs? And Hugh, I want to join with everyone else in wishing you all the best. I hope that I can have as long and as successful a career as you've had. Oh, by the way, do you think you could get me Barbara's direct line phone number? I'm just asking.
Maybe so. Over the years, I have packed my bags hundreds of times on assignment for 2020. And my final story, once again, took me far from home, to the other side of the world. But what I encountered there in Indonesia brought back to me my roots in the Midwest. There was a time when I was growing up in the 20s, when my neck of the woods was called the goiter belt. So many people, and several of them were relatives of mine, suffered from goiters. That's a disfiguring thyroid disorder that doctors finally traced to iodine deficiency. And that discovery was the beginning of iodized salt in this country, the use of iodized salt. But in Indonesia, as in many parts of the world, the importance of something so simple is just beginning to have an impact. Just last month, I traveled to Indonesia to learn about iodine deficiency, or IDD, a disorder potentially more devastating to people here than the chaos in the province of East Timor. The visible consequences of IDD, goiter and severe mental retardation, are rare in our country, where people get the iodine they need from iodized salt and a variety of foods. But here, an estimated 40 million people out of a population of 200 million are at risk for IDD, which lowers IQ an average of 13 points. Stephen Woodhouse, the head of the UNICEF office here, says, what a waste.
And you look at poor children and you think, maybe that child has got the same genetic potential as Albert Einstein. But if that child's not consuming iodized salt, then that potential is not going to be realized.
The answer is as simple as adding iodine to salt.
He doesn't sell salt that doesn't contain iodine. That I'm delighted with, yeah.
Woodhouse is working to see that everybody gets the message. The body needs only a small amount of iodine, but without it, the thyroid gland malfunctions, often leading to goiter, which is an enlarged thyroid. Here in Central Java, the incidence of goiter has decreased from 30% in the late 80s to 10% now. Still, as I explored the problem with UNICEF nutritionist Ernest Schoffelin, we saw a number of goiters. Only one was this size. This woman, Miriam, is 70 and has lived with a goiter most of her life. She told me it was awkward but not painful.
But he has no money. She has no money.
Miriam could never afford the surgery that her sister had to remove a similar goiter. As strange and unsettling as this is, it is not the worst of IDD's devastation. In Sengi village, a teacher brought his students to meet us. They are Cretans. Now, this sounds like a pejorative term, but in fact, it is a medical term. Cretans may be unable to hear or speak.
He can't hear and he can't speak.
Oh, he doesn't hear.
Yeah.
I see.
They may be dwarfs or be severely mentally retarded. This young woman did not know her age. Cretinism occurs when a pregnant woman lacks iodine, especially in the first trimester. The baby's central nervous system does not develop properly, as was the case with this 16-month-old boy.
Was it known right at the time of his birth that this problem existed?
After 3 months.
After 3 months,
yeah.
Then it was known.
So the damage is such that whatever you do, it will never become a normal child.
The severity of cretinism varies widely. Mr. Amin's dwarfism makes his condition obvious. Mrs. Amin's diminished mental capacity is less evident, but both are cretins and parents of two healthy boys.
So both of you are going into medicine.
Iodine was the key. The mother received an injection of iodine in oil very early in each of her pregnancies. The boys are now 16 and 18, and both college students. This area of central Java, long studied by Indonesia's IDD researchers, is just a short drive from one of the country's most popular tourist attractions, the ancient Buddhist temple of Borobudur.
It's a sure bet that when this was built, between 750 and 850 AD, there was no iodine problem. But 1,200 years of volcanoes and floods and soil erosion have depleted nature's supply of iodine. And so here in Indonesia and about 100 other countries in the world, the largest food fortification project ever is underway.
The technology for fortifying table salt with iodine is simple and inexpensive, and the best way to protect the 1.5 billion people at risk for this often hidden problem. Developing countries are getting money and expertise from UNICEF, the International Council for Control of IDD, the World Health Organization, and Kiwanis International, among others.
It's a magnificent effort. The world always looks upon magnificent efforts such as Kosovo and various other military efforts. But if I look at those, I think they pale into insignificance if you look at the effort that is now underway.
Welcome to Friend of Mr. Downs in our chosen TV studio.
All right, thank you.
An energetic boost to the IDD campaign comes from half a world away in High Point, North Carolina.
Could you tell us how you became interested in IDD?
Actually, through UNICEF, as you guys probably did.
Ferndale Middle School has an annual fund drive organized by teacher Vicki Miller. The youngsters, members of the Kiwanis Builders Club, learn IDD is the easiest preventable form of mental retardation. 5 cents worth of iodine is a lifetime supply.
When they saw the videos produced by Kiwanis about the problem with IDD, they want to do something. And when you tell them it's just a nickel, then they say, hey, we can do that.
It made me feel good inside every time I dropped the nickel in the jar.
Because you knew what that nickel was doing.
Yes, sir, it was saving a life.
How much of a dent have you made in that problem with your project?
Not enough.
That's what we're always saying at UNICEF. It's good, but it's not enough. And
young Drew Keaton is right to remain vigilant. The problem is complex. For example, the government of Indonesia passed a law that salt for human consumption be iodized. And this technique, spraying the diluted iodine, though rudimentary, did the job. A few drops of liquid from this salt tester. The bright purple color means sufficient iodine.
Oh, boy. That's iodized, all right.
The difficulty, however, is that there are 30,000 salt producers spread over 13,000 islands, so inspection and quality control are nearly impossible. Shovelin provided some answers about malnutrition.
Because it's a matter of price and of habits.
Even though Indonesia is an island nation, the people don't eat much fish, where they might get some iodine. Their staple is rice. Most of the people we met live on less than a dollar a day for a family. And if it means saving a few pennies, shoppers might choose loose, non-iodized salt, which was all too easy to find.
No, that's not iodized, you're right.
Yeah, that's right.
And that's sold as a consumer product.
The woman told us no inspector had ever been here.
And that's our big challenge now, how to get rid of this salt in these marketplaces.
Ironically, a woman selling iodized salt nearby had an obvious goiter.
That's iodized, yes.
Yeah, very good.
That's the real stuff.
Education is the key. Studying goiter and mental retardation and other effects of IDD starts in the second grade. To stay healthy, alert, and smart, they need smart salt. Without it, there will be more people like Mr. and Mrs. Amin. Unlike smallpox or polio, there is no vaccine to eradicate IDD. Consistent intake of iodine must become second nature to these children. As soon as they stop, the problems come back.
Well, I think it's important to maintain the educational effort over at least 10 to 15 years. So it's ingrained in the national psyche that consuming iodized salt is the only thing to do.
I think it should be like a universal goal, like that everybody's trying to achieve.
I would just tell the people who have IDD that help is on the way and to hang on and not lose faith.
With so many doing so much, these kids might just have a chance at a healthier life.
As we said, most often this is a hidden illness. About 70% of the people who have it don't know it. And all the information you need to know about this disorder is available now at our website at abcnews.com.
What an important story. Well, coming up, the interview that will reveal things about Hugh that only his closest friends like me have known. Stay with us.
Hugh, how can you do this to me, old boy? For heaven's sakes, I've been enjoying you on television and as a friend for a half a century now. When you and I and television itself were pups, we're going to miss you. We're going to miss you a lot. Good luck.
Days until the celebration of the century.
Nothing is worse than the agony of a migraine. But fast-working Migraine Ice, a new cooling, soothing pad, can help make you feel your pain reliever is more effective. Ice your migraine with new Migraine Ice, the new way to help manage your migraine.
Ziploc containers, test number 8. If you can't remember how long they've been in the fridge, just remember, one is affordable enough to throw away. Ziploc, all you ever wanted in a container.
It's the way a house smells when there's bread baking in the oven. The way mothers know how to make sandwiches just right. It's the way we try to know each of our customers by name, or at least by sandwich. And it's the way all your favorite things combine into something even better, right before your eyes. It's probably why people rate us so highly for quality, survey after survey. Even though it can be hard to answer questions with your mouth full. Subway, it's the way a sandwich should be.
Oh, the life of a typical dandruff sufferer. Note his painful isolation, his social embarrassment, his pitiful lack of confidence. Note his dandruff shampoo, Nizoral AD, the world's number one prescribed ingredient for dandruff in non-prescription strength. Just twice a week with Nizoral AD can turn this typical dandruff sufferer into a person free of dandruff. Nizoral AD, the freedom will go to your head.
Introducing a radically new SUV, the new Nissan Xterra. Everything you need, nothing you don't.
ABC turns up the heat.
I'm not going to have this in my family.
I don't care what you say, I love him.
Saturday, Jennifer Lopez stars in the network television premiere of Selena. ABC, a great movie every Saturday night.
Heather has moved into City Hall and everyone's talking.
You need what I have up here.
What? Half a bottle of mousse?
She's a poet, Mike.
Oh, really?
And beautiful and talented.
Caitlin is going down.
Caitlin, you're going straight to the top.
The battle continues on Spin City, followed by It's Like You Know. See you Tuesday on ABC.
Oh, hi, folks. I just want to wish Hugh Downs a happy retirement from 2020. And, of course, he was one of the original announcers right here in The Tonight Show with Jack Parr. And he rides motorcycles. See, a lot of people don't know that. See, that's why when I was a little kid, ooh, that's the guy that announces and rides motorcycles. But always a classy guy, one of the most intelligent, one of the smartest, one of the kindest men on television. And people don't really retire from television. They just show up on that biography show on A&E every couple of weeks. So, Hugh, God bless you. Thanks for being a wonderful role model for every person that ever wanted to do this. Folks, are you excited about Hugh? Look at that. God bless you.
When
2020 will continue after this from our ABC stations.
Tonight at 11, new concerns about the spread of encephalitis after a case is confirmed in Central Park. Plus, you'll hear from a psychic who says she can solve the mystery of a pregnant woman who's been missing for months. Tonight at 11 on ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
Right now, see more trucks than an all-night diner. Join the GMC Summer Convoy. Pickups, SUVs, and family vans. 2 million tons of professional-grade trucks designed better than they need to be. Like the GMC Jimmy, an SUV built with a backbone, a full-length steel frame, and a smooth, comfortable ride. Get $2,000 cash back or 0% APR on select 99 Jimmys. This is one convoy you don't want passing you by.
Take it from a company who's always loved this game, who manages the assets of major league clubs and finances everything from the making of baseball gloves to the building of stadiums, and who this season became an official sponsor of Major League Baseball. There is nothing like the first time you make it to the majors.
Now there's an internet search engine that can actually help you find what you're looking for, with all the best stuff on the internet organized into logical, helpful categories. So don't just look, look smart. Looksmart.com.
Won't you please, please help me, help me, help me.
Your response was overwhelming. Gary Zukav is back Monday's Oprah.
Excuse
me, got this in the cup. 13,
12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
Good evening, I'm Hugh Downs.
Your crack-up was really... this one will hold.
Oh, do I remember that one? Okay, I'll get even one day. Right now, the interview that I have been preparing for since way back when. Watch. You and I have been more or less together on the air now for 35 years.
Hard to believe.
And I have never done an interview with you.
Isn't that weird?
What can I do to make you cry?
You can say that you'll never speak to me again.
Now this is going to be a puff piece. 21 years at 2020 is merely the latest and longest chapter in Hugh's amazing 60-year history in broadcasting. The eldest of the three Downs boys of Akron, Ohio, Hugh says he was a bit timid, hardly likely to spend his life in front of a microphone. Then in 1939, college funds ran out after freshman year. It was the middle of the Depression. Dad said, get a job. So 18-year-old Hugh wandered into the radio station in nearby Lima, Ohio. What was the copy you read in your audition? I'll bet you remember to this day.
Yeah, I do. It was for a sale of house paint. I don't remember the words exactly, but I remember the program director later said, you know, when he heard me read it, he came back in and he said, that was very bad. he said, but great oaks from little acorns grow. And they offered me a job for $12.50 a week. That's how I started in broadcasting.
WLOK led to WMAQ.
Pardon me, please. I should say who I am, shouldn't I? Well, I'm Hugh Downs, one of 14 full-time...
He felt his voice was average, but audiences thought it was warm and confident. A radio career led to a chance at TV. Hugh had never seen a television show when he was asked to read some news copy. It was 1945, so not many other people had either.
Somebody said there were about 345 sets in all of Greater Chicago, and that they were mostly in bars, so I was probably broadcasting to a bunch of drunks.
Do you like watching yourself on television?
No, I don't. I've gotten over getting real sick when I see myself.
Chicago was good for Hugh's professional life and his personal life. You and Ruth had been married for 55 years. Was it love at first sight?
No.
Remember? No.
No, it wasn't. We were both in Chicago, and we worked together for a while before we paid any attention to each other. And later on, the spark was lit.
Hugh and Ruth moved their family, children H.R. and Dee Dee, to New York, where the television industry and Hugh's career were booming.
Yours truly, Hugh Downs, and Jack's guest tonight.
In 1957, Hugh became Jack Parr's stable sidekick on The Tonight Show.
What are you doing? Are you doing a show on the side here?
You were wonderful companions because he was sort of off the wall and had great humor, and you were the steady one, and he almost made you a character, which wasn't tough.
I don't understand this, Hugh, but you will.
He once said, if you ask Hugh Downs what time it is, he tells you how the watch was made.
Yeah. He asked me a lot of questions, and sometimes I could answer it, and that led him to think that I had some great knowledge. He called me a walking encyclopedia. And immediately after, my family, who are constant guardians of my humility, took to calling me a walking pamphlet, which was probably more to the point.
Let's take a look at our concentration board.
Baby boomers might not have been allowed to stay up late to watch Hugh and The Tonight Show, but millions remember the knowledgeable, unflappable host of the daytime quiz show, Concentration.
This is Today in Canada.
Then in 1962, Hugh became host of The Today Show at NBC.
I was a writer on The Today Show when you were hired to be the host. And there were those, especially some of the snobs in news, who said, he doesn't have a journalistic background. What's he doing here? Remember?
Yes, I do.
How do you answer? Or how did you answer them?
I would like to have had a background of a print reporter. I think that's great for journalism. But I don't think to be a communicator with people and what's going on in the world that you have to have that background.
This is Today in Germany. Barbara Walters is here.
You put me on the air. I was a writer, and you put me on the air. I think this is the time to ask if, in all my years of being such a big mouth, you ever regretted it. And if the answer is yes, this will conclude this interview.
I'll tell you what it instills in me is pride. I did feel that that you ought to be on the air for a number of reasons, and I feel I gloated a little bit at having been right.
We had fun. In 1965, I remember that you took a leave of absence. You went away for 3 months from the Today Show to sail the Pacific with your son, H.R. Now, a lot of people said, how can he do that? In 3 months, they'll replace him. That took guts.
I can't tell you why I really had to do it, but I did.
I wonder if people realize that in many ways you're a very stubborn man, that when you decide you want to do something, if you're going to leave something, that's it, and no one can talk you out of it. Isn't that true?
I guess my wife says the same thing you're saying now. I think of myself as very compliant.
Well, I mentioned this because we worked together in the Today Show for 9 years. You were an enormous success. And then you announced you were leaving.
Yeah.
Why?
You know, up until 2020, I always repotted myself after a decade.
Here's the host of Over Easy, Hugh Downs.
Hugh's repotting, trying something new every decade, led him first to Over Easy for public television. Then in 1978 to 2020.
Good evening, I'm Hugh Downs.
What has being on 2020 meant to you?
Oh, a lot. This was the pinnacle of everything I had done and being interested in a lot of things, to be able not only to try to be involved in in-depth things that would enhance people's lives, which a lot of our features do, really, provide a service for people or information that they ought to have.
Is there an adventure that you haven't had that you'd like to have?
Yes.
What?
Yes. I would like very much to go into space. If they ever did that again, I said to John Glenn when we finished this thing of his return to space, and we're both the same age, and I said, you know, 10 years from now, if the government wants to find out how 87-year-olds fare in space, let's both go. And he said, you're on. And I would do it. I would do it at the drop of a hat.
How old do you feel? You're 78.
Yeah.
Yes. How old do you feel?
Well, I feel like about 35. I notice that my margins are a little thinner. I can't get the abuse that I had physically that I did when I was younger. But why should I? You know, I don't have to do that.
Does getting older scare you?
No. If I get so I can't get on a horse or scuba dive or something, there's a lot of music to listen to, and there's a lot of reading to do. So I don't think I would repine about that. But I do have a slight dread of a kind of deterioration that I would not want to live with. The shipwreck of old age.
I don't think that's going to happen here.
Maybe not.
Have there been issues that you would like to have spoken out on? Because you have some very strong opinions.
You bet.
That you have not been able to. This is your chance.
It is.
I hope.
I never thought of it.
We'll try to
keep
this
in. As you know from 2020 and a couple of times back, I have made comments about the insanity of our drug policy in this country.
Are you for the legalization of marijuana?
The decriminalization of marijuana, yes. I think that would be important, particularly the medical use of it. You know, I think it's ludicrous that states have voted that a medical use is a proper use of that, and yet the federal government countermands that and causes a problem for sick people, but I'm in favor of it.
And this is something until now you've not been able to talk about on television.
No, not a couple of times I poked at it a little bit in years past, but the roof fell on me so hard that I decided to back off.
Anything else you'd like to get off your chest?
I'd like to see a little less mean-spiritedness among our government people in, you know, where we're not trying to make homelessness a crime or above all, try to move religion into politics, which I think is a very dangerous thing when the separation of church and state is so important. Those are kind of editorial ideas I have.
I want to ask you some questions just for fun, okay? Mm. What is the most overrated virtue?
Maybe chastity in itself is an overrated virtue. I'm not advocating licentiousness, but I think there's been so much made of that lately that it's created almost a psychosis in our society.
What would you consider perfect happiness?
Well, perfect happiness, I think might be to be able to keep your health indefinitely. This is quite utopian and out of bounds of reality. And to have time with my wife, just 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, doing the things we like to do. That sounds corny, but that's really what my idea of happiness is.
There are some things I know about you that other people don't. I know that you're very funny. A lot of people, I think, see you as very serious. And you have your funny smiles. Will you show us the smiles that you only show me off camera?
Oh, yeah. Well, the Texas smile.
Sure.
My Texas smile is this. I don't know why I have known Texans that smile like that. But the other one is the aristocrat. The aristocrat looks like this.
Now, no one has ever seen you like that before.
I guess not.
I have only one more question.
What's that?
How am I going to get along without you?
Oh, bless you. You'll get along fine, and I hope... Yeah, that's one of my real regrets, is that working with you has been icing on the cake for me. I think, in fact, since when? 1962, when you first got me welcomed onto the Today Show, we've worked together almost nonstop, and it's been something I'll miss greatly.
It's been the icing on the cake for you. It's the cake for me.
Thank you, my dear.
It sure is, and you have said it before, and I'm going to say it now. You are not retiring. You're just changing directions.
Just transition. Yeah, for one thing, I'll be in touch on the Internet now at exbtv.com. I'm going to be giving reports and commentary on the goings-on in the executive branch of our government. I'll also be continuing my work with UNICEF, and I've been invited to lecture at Arizona State University's new communications school.
Which we should mention was recently named the Hugh Downs School of Human Communication, and that's quite an honor. And if all of that isn't enough, Hugh is a composer, a piece he wrote for piano, has just come out on CD. John Bell Young played it on the America's label, and the renowned cellist Yo-Yo Ma will be premiering Hugh's cello composition next year with the St. Louis Symphony. Whew, new adventures for the next 21 years.
Life, as they say, is good.
Okay, don't go away, because we have a few more surprises in store that you won't want to miss.
Hey, how about replacing your refrigerator with one that's a little less,
avocado?
Yeah.
I would love to.
Well, Sears has great deals on electronics and appliances, even Kenmore refrigerators.
Kenmore's great.
Plus, right now, you can get 0% finance charge until September 2000 with your Sears card.
Wow.
Just buy any appliance over $399 or electronic over $499, and hey, no finance charge until September 2000. So?
I'm finally gonna get a fridge that doesn't leave me cold.
Good thing, but you better hurry. Sale ends Saturday.
Why do people believe nothing works better than Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine?
It just breaks up my nasal congestion so that I can finally breathe.
Alka-Seltzer Plus? It effervesces and gets the medicine moving.
It's great at breaking up my cold.
Only Alka-Seltzer Plus has the power of effervescence. It gets the medicine moving to break up your worst cold symptoms fast. Nothing breaks up your cold better than Alka-Seltzer Plus.
It just works.
Adrenaline, the new Lincoln LS.
When you're listening to life, you hear the lessons. Sometimes they surprise. I realized it was here, at this very PetSmart, where I adopted Ruff. He remembered Debbie's kind voice. So did I. See, at PetSmart, cats and dogs aren't sold. They're adopted. Family.
2020, now in its 21st anniversary year, winner of over 300 prestigious awards for excellence in broadcast journalism.
Oh, Michigan, Wisconsin, Saturday.
The Wisconsin Badger's gonna be there.
Well, yeah, so my man Ron Dane.
ABC Sunday. Two David Kelly shows, one great premiere night. First, Snoops, the new series critics say will be huge. Then, The Practice, the winner of four Emmys, including Best Drama, is back. Catch Snoops series premiere, followed by The Practice season premiere. ABC Sunday, starting at 9, 8 Central.
Gotcha. Good evening.
I know, license and registration.
Kurt Brewer. I've been wanting to talk to you.
Me?
You're the fund manager for my large cap fund.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So notice you made the top 10.
Yeah. Yeah.
But not the top 5. Let's put the clubs away and get back to the office.
It's time for the E-Trade Mutual Fund Center. Instant scrutiny of over 4,700 funds.
If IKEA can update this classic, imagine the possibilities for your home. Affordable furniture and the rest, all in IKEA's new catalog.
Hugh, I think what I remember most vividly from our days in Chicago half a century ago was you and Dave Garraway in the announcer's lounge at WMAQ in Chicago rolling that big Webster's Dictionary back and forth. And she kept betting each other a buck that you could come up with a word the other guy couldn't define. Word was that she almost bankrupted Dave Garraway. Warm, happy memories, Hugh. And admiration, too, for putting up with Barbara for so many years.
I love you, too, Mike. Well, now, there are a few people. Here we go. These are all of our 2020 anchors.
Oh, my God.
All of them asked to be here tonight to send you their best wishes.
I couldn't figure what was happening. Hey, my God, all of you.
A little back rub after 21 years.
Probably
we never
needed.
Get to stand behind you.
And they have
and
all been waiting.
Best you.
I've worked on every one of them. And
I like the part about getting on the horse.
You love. That's right, with your ranch. That's
I'm
right.
I'm going to follow you to the internet, too.
That's right, Sam's going on the internet.
You know, the time has come now for all of us to say goodbye to you, at least on the air, because for me, our off-the-air friendship will never end.
No.
I have had 35 years of support and humor and wisdom and kindness from, oh, I don't want to do this, from one of the finest gentlemen I have ever known. And we've shared some bad moments, but we've had an awful lot of good ones, haven't we? And now I know that few people can claim the kind of partnership that we've had. And all these people behind me, I can safely say, feel the same enormous respect and affection for you that I have, don't you?
Bravo. Yeah.
And they have expressed their personal sentiments, oh, we save no expense, in a card especially made for you with all of our names and all of our love.
Oh, yeah.
So be well and be happy, my friend. And I know that you should know that you're cherished by the audience and by each and every one of us. I will be doing 2020 on Fridays alone from now on, because the truth is, Hugh, that you are irreplaceable. And now before I start to blubber all over the place, I know that you want to add your own personal farewell, and when we come back, the stage is all yours. Stay with us.
What a surprise.
Coming up next on Eyewitness News, new concerns about the spread of encephalitis after a case is confirmed in Central Park. Plus, you'll hear from a psychic who says she can solve the mystery of a pregnant woman who's been missing for months on ABC7 Eyewitness News. Next.
If you're using two products, one to kill germs and one to shine your kitchen, it can feel like you've got two of everything. It doesn't have to. Introducing Windex Antibacterial Glass and Surface Cleaner. The first antibacterial that not only kills tough germs, but leaves a streak-free Windex shine. Without the film, the leading antibacterial can leave behind. So why deal with two unless you have to?
Mom, hungry!
Now try Windex Antibacterial. It's time for a germ-free shine. S.C. Johnson. Did somebody say McDonald's?
You know, I wonder if you can fix that truck again.
E-tailers like Amazon.com choose Priority Mail. Shouldn't you?
Well, it's been written, there is something in the pang of change more than the heart can bear. Right now, my heart can attest to that. It was predictable how I would feel on parting company with the people I've worked with for so long. Every one of them displays the highest level of professionalism, and I have reaped the benefits of their exceptional abilities. I want to thank them. They have my admiration and my deepest affection. And I want to thank you, the best audience I have known in six decades of broadcasting. To each of you and your family, I send out my warmest wishes for your personal well-being and for the safety and health of our country as well. We used to close each program urging you to keep in touch with us, and you have done so. And I now want to urge you to keep on keeping in touch with 2020. I don't think you'll go wrong doing that. I'm Hugh Downs, and for now, good night.
This has been a presentation of ABC News. More Americans get their news from ABC News than from any other source.
San Francisco, Arizona, Monday night at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific.
Next on Eyewitness News, a second strain of encephalitis is found as the assault against mosquitoes intensifies. And the last will and testament of John F. Kennedy Jr., what he left behind and to whom.
Numbers for Take 5 next on Eyewitness News.
This is the news leader, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
Tonight, another round of spraying for mosquitoes in our area, and there are two new developments. A new strain of a potentially deadly virus never before seen in this country is found, and the first case of St. Louis encephalitis is linked directly to Manhattan.
Good evening, I'm Bill Butel.
And I'm Diana Williams.
Tonight, health officials say they have discovered another virus carried by mosquitoes in our area. It is the West Nile virus, never before seen in the Western Hemisphere. It comes to light as the first case of encephalitis is confirmed in Manhattan, and birds by the dozens are dropping dead from New York to Connecticut. Jim Dolan is live in Central Park taking along this story now. Jim, good evening.
Good evening, Bill. The St. Louis encephalitis virus tonight and the outbreak around it got a lot more complicated and a lot more widespread as well. Because as it turns out, it's not just one virus, it's two. And it's not just the city in Westchester County affected, it's Suffolk County as well. And one more thing, health officials have been wondering for months what's been killing so many birds in our area. Now they know it's the same two.